In this episode, we're going to demystify demand forecasting. We're going to explore what it is, why it matters, and how businesses use it to anticipate customer needs and optimize their operations. Well, hello, everyone. Welcome back. I'm Professor Rodriguez, and today in Supply Chain Management Explained in Under 10 Minutes, we're going to dive deeper into the fascinating world of demand forecasting. At least I find it fascinating. I hope you do too. We're going to talk about what it is, why is it crucial, and how does it work. So what do you say? Buckle up and let's get started with demand forecasting in under 10 minutes. Okay, so let's begin with the basics. Demand forecasting, if I could explain it to you or how I explain to it to my students, demand forecasting is like peering or peeking into a crystal ball for businesses. It is really the process of predicting what customers want, how much they want, and when they want it. In essence, it is all about anticipated future demand for products or services. Now, if you ask, why is demand forecasting important? Well, let me tell you. It is important because it gives us a way to determine or kind of predict how much consumers are willing to purchase from us. So imagine a scenario where a retailer underestimates the demand for one of their hot-selling products. Well, what ends up happening is that customers walk into the store or go online only to find that the product is not there on the shelves or not available online. Well, for consumers, frustration is going to set in and they might turn to a competitor to purchase the same product that they needed because the need is still there. The consumer still wants that hot item, but they're not going to be able to get it from us because we underestimated how much the consumer wanted it. On the flip side, if a business overestimates demand, that they're going to be stuck with a surplus of inventory, which ends up tying up capital or money and taking up valuable storage space in their warehouse systems. Both scenarios can be costly and damaging to a business reputation and overall health. Now that we know what it is, now that we understand why demand forecasting is vital, let's explore its applications. In manufacturing, demand forecasting helps in planning production schedules. Businesses can align their production with anticipated demand, avoiding overproducing or underproducing. In distribution, it ensures that the right amount of product is available at the right locations. This means that customers get what they want when they want it. Even in sales and marketing teams, demand forecasting helps. They can tailor promotions and marketing campaigns based on anticipated demand, which maximizes their effectiveness overall. Lastly, finance departments can also rely on demand forecasting for budgeting and financial planning because it helps them allocate resources more effectively. Now let's look at some real-world examples. Imagine you run a smartphone manufacturing company. You've analyzed the historical sales data, the market trends, and even consider external factors like the launch of a competitor's product. Well, you decide to ramp up production, ensure an adequate supply of components, and inform your retail partners to prepare for the rush. When the holiday season arrives, your customers find your product readily available and sales soar. Your demand forecast paid off. Whether you're a student or a professional or a business owner yourself, demand forecasting is a valuable tool in the world of logistics and supply chain management. If you found this information valuable, please hit the subscribe button to stay updated on more insights into supply chain management. And remember, the future is uncertain. We are in 2024 now or whenever you're watching this at whatever time. But you know, the future is uncertain, but with demand forecasting, you can make it a little less so. I want to thank you for joining me today. I'll see you in the next episode of Supply Chain Management Explained in 10 Minutes. Until next time, keep forecasting, keep innovating, and keep learning all about supply chain and logistics. See you soon. Bye.